Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about settings, option, function keys, how we can navigate from one screen to another screen, how we can go back to previous screen, and how to start a new screen, swap list, ISPF 3.1 and ISPF 3.2, 3.3 and 3.4 options. So we are going to discuss all these topics in this video. Start is a TSO command, swap list is a TSO command, ISPF 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 3.4 are options of the Interactive System Productivity Facility. ISPF stands Interactive System Productivity Facility panel, options. Settings, to change the settings of the, your session, not emulator settings, your options of the server. Okay, according to your convenience, we can change the few options in once you connect to the server. So what is function keys? All of them we are going to see. Let's see team directly everything. We will be discussing everything in the mainframe now. So already I connected to mainframe server and logged in successfully. So as we discussed in our earlier videos, this is ISPF primary option menu screen. So this is ISPF primary option menu. We are having action. This is called action bar. Top line we call as an action bar, menu, utilities, compilers, options, status, help. These are all called action bars on ISPF panel. The entire screen we can call as a panel or page. Some users will call as a panel, few users will call as a page. On each screen there will be action bar. Within the action bar, there is a pull choice option. Okay, so if I click on, if I enter the on menu option, I can see sub options of the menu. Similarly, if I click on, if I hit the enter on options, so place the cursor on options, hit the enter, automatically we can able to see options of the options from menu bar. Click on status. Place the cursor on status, hit the enter, you can see the options. So this is all about your action bar on ISPF panel on pull choice options. On the bottom of the screen, you can see function keys. Bottom of the screen, you can see function keys. In mainframe, we use frequently function keys. Without function keys, we don't do anything in mainframe. Because if I want to go back to the previous page, previous screen, I have to use function key, right? So hence, function keys are very, very important. So this is all about your ISPF panel screen. Now, on ISPF primary option menu, we are having options called 0, that is settings. If you want to change the terminal user parameter values, then we can give 0. So type on command line 0, hit the enter, we can see ISPF settings screen. So according to your requirement, we can change the options values. Then here we can see from in the menu bar, options are got changed. So options, nothing but action bar, options are not always fixed. It keep on varies. Okay, depends on the screen where you are. So on this screen, few options will be there. If you go to the fourth screen, options will be different or might be the same. Okay, so at the same time, you don't need to focus much on it. Unless if you have some specific requirement. Now we are in ISPF settings option. How we can go back to the previous screen on the server? How we can go back to the previous screen? Press F3. F3 is the function key to go back to the previous screen. If you want to go back to the previous screen, we have to press F3. Now again we are on ISPF primary option menu. So we have seen what is zero, right? Now I am doing again on command line. I am pressing or I am typing zero. Indicates you are trying to enter, you are trying to go to this particular settings option screen. Hit the enter. Now I will give you one small example. If you want to enable euro sign symbol, okay, if you want to enable euro sign symbol, select it. Okay, there is option, you have to select it. Now euro sign symbol is available, right? Enabled. Now command line, it is printing on top of the screen. Let's say you want to print bottom of the screen, then our page. So I can select slash, hit the enter. The command line is showing at the end of it, at the bottom. So it might vary, it might vary on as per the user convenience, as user flexibility. So we can change these settings. Now I'm very much habituated and flexible with the command line if it is a top. So that is the reason I'm unselecting it. So if I delete, okay, just go there, delete it. So if you delete it, automatically it will remove. Hit the enter, it goes to the top. Now press F3. So this is all about settings team. Okay, so we don't do much in zero option on daily basis or even occasionally also. Now we have something option called one. So what is the option one? View. If you want to view the data from the file, so you can select one, view, and we need to enter the file name or data set name. So once we enter the file name or data set name, we can see the content of that particular file. So this is all about first option. What is the use of one? To view the source data or listing. If you want to see what are the data sets are there with particular pattern, or if you want to browse the content, if you want to browse the content of the file, it can be PS file, it can be a PDF, then we need to go with the option one. Next, two. So here you can view the data, but you will be having less options to modify, but there is possibility of modification, but we will see. Okay, so in further sessions or okay, somewhere we'll see about differences between view and edit. Now if I select second option, I can modify existing data. So through ISPF option, so I can open a data set, I can modify it. So that is all about. So I'm selecting, I'm typing on command line two, hit the enter. Again, what the panel is appearing in view screen, same panel will be here also. Okay, so the main difference will come when you're trying to enter the data. So we can select the data set name. Now I am pressing F3. So we are done view option discussion. We are done with the edit option discussion. Now three, that is utilities. So this is very, very important. So in our course, that is Introduction to Mainframe and TSYSPF course, we are going to focus on utilities option. Select 3 and hit the enter. There are so many sub options are there. So if you want to allocate a new data set, or if you want to rename a data set, or if you want to delete, so catalog, uncatalog, if you want to see the existing file attributes information, then we will be selecting option 2. So 3.2 is mainly for allocating a file, or you can rename, or you can delete, catalog, uncatalog. We can see the information of the data set. Move and copy. If you want to move the data from one data set to another data set, if you want to copy the members from one PDS to another PDS, we will be using third option. Next, fourth, data set list. If you want to browse the data sets, means you want to see what are the data sets are created by you. You want to list out based on pattern, then we will be going with option called 4. Then, so another important options where you can explore, that is Super CE. So these two options to compare two files. So 13 has more features compared to 12. So 3.12, what we call 3.12, because utilities is a third option, sub option is 12. So 3.12 means comparing two files. Okay, so if you want to go with some advanced features during comparison, we will be selecting 3.13. Okay, press F8. If you press F8, you can see bottom data. Okay, if you press F8, we can see bottom data. So you can observe here 3.14, 3.15, nothing but 14 and 15. If you want to find a string in a PDS or in multiple PDSS files, we will be going with the 14 and 15 option. So these are all the options are important. So one is 3.2, 3.3, 3.4. So 3.2, 3.3, 3.4, 3.12, 3.13, 3.14, 3.15. So these are all options are very important. So 3 means utilities panel. In the utilities panel, what is the sub option? 2. So in this way, we can go to particular screen. So if I want to go back to the previous screen, press F3. We discussed utilities option. There are so many sub options are there. So there are other options are there too. So these are all not important as part of this course, but yes, if you are a mainframe resources, if you want to, you are working on mainframe, then you should aware of this option. May not be all of them, at least be of them. So let's go back to the one. So you have seen settings. I will talk about function keys in detail. Screen navigation, how we can do start, swap list, all of them we will see. So I have explained you in high level 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 3.4. So don't worry about this options team. In our next video, we are going to focus on 3.2, 3.3, 3.4 options practically. So let's try to understand how we can switch between multiple screens, right? So team, once I logged in, so once I connected to server and log in successfully, I can able to see ISPO primary option menu. So don't think that always we will be landed on this page in everywhere. No team, it is not correct. Depends on the server which you are using. So once you log in, you will be landed on a different panel. So if you logged in a client system, you will be landed in another page. But ultimately, you have to come back to the, irrespective of what are the other screens are there. So at last, you have to come to this panel. Okay. So you might be coming from different option, but you have to come to this screen only. So the ISPO primary option menu is very important. Then this is the first screen, screen one. So we can see what is the user ID I use to do login, time, TSO logon, TSO prefix, and other details, right? So I want to open another session. So I want to be on this screen only. I want to be in this screen only, but I have to open another screen, not session. I have to open another screen. So start indicates opening another ISPO primary option menu. So I'm typing start command, hit the enter. Okay, so you can see now it got changed the option. On the bottom, earlier only one option is there, now we are able to see two. Now I am typing start three, mean go to ISPO panel. On ISPO panel, select the third option, go to the third option screen. Now you can see we are in utility panel screen, utility selection screen. So in this way, we can open new screen. So what is the command we are going to use? Start. So I can use start 3.14. So opening ISPO panel screen, primary menu. From there, we are selecting three, that is utilities, 14 option, like this. So I can select 3.2 or 6 or 1. So whichever the options are valid on that particular screen, you can select it. Now, so I have opened multiple screens, but I want to know how many screens I opened. I want to know them. So swap space list. Swap space list is a TSO command to know the number of screens are opened as of now, are present, or at this moment, how many screens are there. So at this moment, there are three screens are available. Now, here you should notice what is the meaning of star. Currently you are on the screen. So if you swap it, you will be going to from third screen to second screen. If I swap it, we will be swapping between second and third. So star is nothing but the current screen. Before that, we have opened a screen most of the time, that is second. So if I want to go back to the previous screen, press F3. So I'm again repeating the same last point. Swap list is the command to get the number of screens are opened at this moment. Type swap list command, hit the enter. You can see 1, 2, 3. Third screen, star indicates you are on current panel. This third utility, that screen is current utility, is current panel screen. Hyphen, when you swap it, it will go to second. Now, like this, maximum eight sessions or eight screens we can create. So now we are having three only. If you want to have few more, yes, we can do with the start option. Let's say team, from this screen I want to go to first screen, so I can type yes. So wherever dot is there, just you type yes. So we are going to first screen, so screen number one. Okay, so and you can see star is here. So if I press F9, okay, if I press F9, swapping is going to happen between the first and the second F9. So F9 is the command, function key to swap between two screens which are recently opened. So what are the screens you recently opened? Among the top recently opened screens, it is going to happen swap. So F9, press F9. Okay, so now I have opened three screens. It is swapping only between them, first and second. But there is a situation where I want to see, or where I want to go to third screen. On command line, type 3, press F9. Okay, so if I want to go to first screen, on command line, press the screen number, press F9. You can see screen number one. Okay, so if I want to go to second screen, 2 and F9. So in this way we can navigate it to particular screen easily. So I am typing another, I am opening another screen, start SCST. I'm going to the spool. Okay, what is spool, that we will discuss later, and it will be there in another course. At this moment, just understand what is how to navigate to the spool. So start SST. So I am in the spool. Now we can see total there are 4 screens are there. If I want to go to specific screen, on command line, press the screen number and F9. 1 F9, 3 F9, moving to the third screen. In this way, we can go to specific screen. So let's go back to our slide. So we had a discussion on settings. We had a discussion on function keys. We discussed only one function key, that is F3 and F9, F8. If you want to see below data, okay, so what is F8? Now you can see at this moment we are able to see only 14 options, but there are few more. Can you see more plus? What this indicates? Yes, there are few more options are there. So then how I can see them? Do I need to hit the enter? No, you have to press F8. So now you can see, you are able to see 15, 16, 17. Earlier, we were able to see till 14. Now, we are able to see 15, 16, 17. Now, minus indicates that there is no bottom data, but it is there on something on the top. Okay, so you can see. Okay, minus indicates something it is there on top. You press F7 to go back to go to the tops. If you want to see the top data, F7. If you want to see the bottom data, we use F8. Like in the web application, if there are 10 pages, when there are 10, there are 1000 paragraphs are there in an article, what we do, we'll keep on scrolling, right? So we use mouse to scroll down, scroll up. So scroll down is nothing but F8, scroll up is nothing but F7. So F7, F3 to go back to the previous screen, F7 to see the up data, F8 to see this bottom data, F9 to swap the screens. So these are all the function keys at this moment we discussed. So if you want to know the help on this particular page, you want to know what are the options, if you want to get some more details about this particular page, you press F1. F1 to get the help. F1 to get the help about this page. So these are all so these are all the things about how we can, you know, do settings, how we can do function, how we can able to, you know, use function keys, screen navigation, swap list, start command, ISPF options in high level. In next video, we are going to see few more topics. Thank you, team.